Ramoja issue. In fact, we have worsened by calling it an APAC issue. These children are Ugandan. They are not Karmojong alone. They are not NAPAC children, they are Ugandans. And so that is why I want to appeal to you to look at that. Gaze at them gazing at you, asking for an answer, asking for a future. It is a future of a whole lot of 15-year children who have actually been born in the street. And this is all generation, colleagues. It is all generation. We have about 3 sub-counties that have been affected in NAPAC. Lopei, Lokopo, and Matang. They are getting emptied into the streets. And just imagine for 20 years or 15, you have actually gotten people getting out. I'm not worried about voters, but I'm worried about them. That is why I want us to be able to look at this particular issue with more concern, with more care, because Karamoja is in Uganda. NAPAC is in Uganda. There are many push factors, and I think Faith has already alluded to them. This particular problem started around 2001 when there was a disarmament and many children were actually running away. It is required they are firing again because in 2019 there is a lot of insecurity.
You're over.
Honorable Speaker, this is a very touchy issue for me. I don't know if you just allow one moment.
Yeah, it is touchy for everyone.
Yeah, so we are basically saying there are lots of push factors and insecurity is one. Now, insecurity has actually assumed worse situations. Many people do not stay in their villages. They have started moving to the centers. And if you are talking about people coming to the streets, they come from the centers because they cannot be able to afford staying in a very insecure environment in the villages. And as I've already said, lots of credible information is out there. But it is us to be able to hold this particular crime, particular problem, with both hands, not only the Karamoja issue, not only NAPAC issue, but all of us. And so it's my prayer, right, Honorable Speaker, that we actually educate these children. There should be a deliberate attempt to be able to educate these children, for them to be able to get some kind of future. The second appeal and prayer, Honorable Speaker, is that we start thinking about how to reintegrate, but also to resettle, in a manner that we are not dropping them, just like we are dropping rubbish. We should be able to deliberately think about how to deal with them when they return back home. Honorable Speaker, I
thank you. Thank you, Honorable Scott.